Hello YouTube and hello to my dear subscribers. Welcome to another video from Karda. It has been quite a while, I think two or maybe 3 weeks since I released my latest video. And I have played some games meanwhile which I want to talk about. And I can make separate videos for all the games that I played or tried playing, but I just combine them all in this one gaming log video. So I'm gonna talk about a little bit the games I have been playing, and do I like them or not, and where I left off with my last video was with Xenoblade Chronicles, which I played quite some hours. But when there was a game coming out end of last month, and I decided to buy it and try it out myself and see if it's as good as I hoped it is would be. And that's the game that I started playing, so I put Xenoblade Chronicles in the backlog so I can continue it. I got my save file and everything, so I can continue whenever I want. And the game that I bought last month, I bought it, Grand Theft Auto 5. And that's a game not very common for RPG player that cannot play shooters. But I really, really, really wanted to see myself how Grand Theft Auto 5 had become. I never liked Grand Theft Auto 4. And, well, they have been working about 5 years on this title, so I just wanted to try it out. So I bought it, and then I had 2 weeks to play offline before online got released. So my first 2 weeks with this game was offline. And it is really, truly amazing how the game looks, how the world works. Like, I was amazed by Xenoblade Chronicles on the Wii. I am as amazed with Grand Theft Auto 5 on the PlayStation 3. What they were able to push out that console was amazing. If I had bought this game on the if it was a PlayStation 4 title, then I would say, wow, look what the PlayStation 4 is able to do. The PlayStation 3 would never have been able to process all this, all these cars and people and the world. But it's a PlayStation 3 title, and they really pushed the PlayStation 3 to the max. The world is amazing. It's quite a big world, and every square mile is built with attention. Not like Skyrim, for example. Skyrim has a big map, but well, they put a forest somewhere, and that's just place a lot of trees. But this game, each square mile is built with like I said, it's truly amazing. And there are quite some quests to do. There are 59 story quests to play to complete the game. And so single player I had a good experience. And with online I played it, it's been 2 weeks now, or what, I think online has been released two weeks ago. So I've been playing online for 2 weeks, and it's a bit MMO RPG stylish. You have to earn money to buy vehicles or an apartment. But at the moment I am quite done playing Grand Theft Auto online. Lots of missions are basically the same. That is, start from point A, drive to point B, collect item C, drive back to point A, and copy paste that ID and you get lots of jobs or missions to do. But they all feel kind of the same. But there are other things, of course, to do. You can race. But if you like racing, you better play GT. What's that game called? Gran Turismo. There are death matches, but I'm very bad in death match, so I can skip that as well. The only thing I like very much is the survival mode, where you have to fight off enemies. And basically that's with four players, and well, that's a mode that I can enjoy. But at the moment I've had enough of Grand Theft Auto, and it was an amazing experience I had with that game. So I went looking after Grand Theft Auto what game to play, and I opened my PlayStation 3 box, and I decided to give Hyperdimension Neptunia MK2 a try. And well, it's a game that it absolutely does not pull me in to continue playing for hours. Basically when I start playing it again, it's 30 minutes or 60 minutes, and then I have more than enough for that session. It feels like it's even a cheaper version of Hyperdimension Neptunia 1, and that also I gave Hyperdimension Neptunia a 7, and this it's not a bad game, but like I said, it doesn't pull me in like I hoped it would do. So it's basically for 30 minutes or 60 minutes Hyperdimension MK2, and I'll try to continue playing it each day a little bit. And basically the same I have, I don't know, maybe I'm spoiled with Xenoblade and Persona 4 Golden and games like that. Then I'm not enjoying other games very much. The same problem I have with Disgaea D2 actually. After playing so much of other Disgaea games, it's still Disgaea, and while this game has my favorite characters in it, somehow it doesn't pull me in like I hoped it would do, like Hyperdimension Neptunia. So Disgaea D2, I even stopped playing for the 30 minute sessions daily. So I got my save file, I can continue whenever I like. And yesterday I bought Dragon's Crown for the PlayStation Vita. There's the PlayStation 3 version and the Vita version, and the Vita has so little games to play on it, and I sometimes want to play on the Vita, so basically because at least my Vita has some use, I bought the Vita version. And Dragon's Crown, it's RPG-ish. It is RPG-ish. What I like about the game is how it looks. The environments and the characters are very, very nice drawn. I think they look very nice. I like the part of the narrator. Excuse my pronunciation, I do not know how to pronounce it. Narrator or narrator. The one who talks the story. I like that very much. And so in each level where you go, he tells a little bit about the history or about quests. So that's the good part, and also good part is it's of course an Atlus game. But it's also this game is not a game that pulls me in to play like 5 or 6 hours behind each other to make a session of 5 hours. I cannot do that with this game. It's also a game I like to play for 30 minutes or 60 and then do something else. But it's a reasonable good game. Battle system is a bit fighting, so it's not really not at all turn based. And it's a fighting game with RPG elements in it. And it looks good, but it did not pull me in like this Gaia D2 or Hyperdimension Neptunia MK2. So I'm still looking for a game that that pulls me in. And due to my good experiences with Persona 4 and Persona 3, I decided to start this evening with Persona 2. And what I found out on the internet, there are two Persona 2 games. The first one is Innocent Sin and the second one is Eternity something. And Innocent Sins has been released on the PlayStation Portable, and most people agree that the PlayStation Portable version is better to enjoy than the PlayStation 1 version, so I'm gonna play the PlayStation Portable version for Innocent Sin. And if I like it and end playing it, then I can continue with the PlayStation 1 Eternal something title. So I'm probably, this is the European version of Persona 2, which has been released by Ghostlight. And I'm probably gonna unbox this this evening, and I hope I gonna like Persona 2 like I did Persona 3 and Persona 4, so I have a game that I want to continue playing, and that's not a feeling I have with Dragon's Crown or Hyperdimension, but I'm gonna continue playing those two with very short sessions daily. So and I tried playing this game as well, by the way, Soul Hackers. And well, that's really some experience I had with it. So I heard so many good things about it, and I tried playing it with the I went in the first dungeon, and then you have to go to some floors. And on the fifth floor, there was a monster that, when you start, you get another character. And I had the healer in the back row, and I put my healer on defend. And the monster did an attack and killed my healer. So that was the end of that gaming session. And so far, I have not continued playing this. It is a remake, I understand that, but they, to my opinion, could have done a better job remaking the graphics. To release this on the 3DS could have been much better, but it's basically more a port than a remake. So that was a little bit disappointment, and like I said, my healer got killed and I did not continue playing after that. So I have to start over one day and try it out again. So my hopes are on Persona 2. There are not many reviews on YouTube, what I noticed. Most is gameplay, and but I do not want to like, I do not like to watch gameplay videos before playing a game. A review is okay when somebody is just talking about it, but I do not want to see the gameplay too much. That spoils the fun a lot. So I'm gonna keep it by that, or keep it with that. Thank you for watching. I'll let you know if I like Persona 2, yes or no. And I really hope it's a game I'm gonna enjoy. Thank you for watching. You'll see me next time. And bye bye from Carda.